name is Shiela Humphries. I'm from Perth, Western Australia. I'm also from the Stolen Generation. I was born in 1940, was taken away from mum and dad at the age of 8. There was a standing alert, the West Australian police, to arrest and apprehend myself and my sister on site. I remember being with mum and dad for 3 months of my life. We were arrested. We were taken back to Nausea, and that's where I spent my childhood for 40 years. I lived in Northwich. I had parents, but my parents were alive. After we were removed from mum and dad, 2 years, mum passed on. We didn't get to know her family until 7 years ago. I tried chasing mother. She was also from the Stolen Generation. She was removed as a 4-year-old, placed in different institutions in Perth. Every time she was placed in a new institution, they baptized her into a different religion, gave her a new name. Mother Darling had 9 Christian names. So hard to find her. We only knew her by the name Evangeline, which was the last name given to her when she was placed in Nausea as a 14-year-old. I get very angry when I look at Mum and Dad's marriage certificate. Dad was a 36-year-old widower. Mum was only 17. The American was arranged by government. As you can see, my skin is fair. She had a white father. To wipe out blank, they married her to my dad and his daughter. They did the same at me. My husband was dark, a wonderful Christian man, Aboriginal guy. My marriage was arranged. He went to his grave. Not knowing that your marriage was arranged. Our government has a lot to answer for. When I left the home, I want to live on my own. Tin shack, dirt floor, about 50 odd people on this earth, 1/12 of females, 1/12 of males, a laundry with a big copper, 2 big wash troughs and then pumps. We lived in tin shacks. We found sheets of iron in the rubbish tip, made our camps, dirt floor, no cooking facilities, one tap on the reserve, we had to carve our water. And guess what? My people are still in America today. What suffered the government of Australia. They get a brain in their head. We're people. We're humans exactly like you. Our skin might be a little lighter. Well, we get a heart. We get a brain. With the blood running through our veins, we humans were not animals. When Mother passed away, we were in the laundry. Now the orphanage had a laundry, we had industrial machinery. Our education finished when we were 12, 13. We were still in the orphanage, but we went into the laundry to work. We did laundry for the around 10 girls during my time, 60 Aboriginal boys, 205 white boys from St. Anne Francis College, 60 monks and 30 nuns. Now that's a lot of work. We had to have all that finished in 3 days. At the age of 14, believe it or not, I could iron 200 shirts. Some of the boys sent 10 shirts in their laundry bags. Our schooling, as I said, 12:30, we no longer went to school. When I got married, my children started school. I couldn't help them. I didn't have an education. When my youngest, we had 8 children, when my youngest started school, I decided to go and further my education. I enrolled in a college. At that time, I thought that it was a place where they were given education to Aboriginal adults to learn how to read and write. I enrolled in a full-time college. Didn't know the first thing about badges or anything else. I sat with a dictionary by my side and scribbled right through my human development book. On graduating, first I went 6 months and I said to my late husband, I can't do this, it's too much for me. He said, no, you go back. I know you can. The following year saw me back in college. I graduated, went to work for community services at the time as an officer in a juvenile detention centre. I spent 10 years working with the department. People ask me, because these were the very people that took me away from my family. People often ask me, why did you go and work for them? My answer to that was, if I can help one child make it in this world, work it all. From there, I'm still working today. I'll be 77 this year. I go into schools down the church and teach everything up. I also teach stolen generation in schools. To visitors from around the world, to mining companies, you know. I had a group of 12 doctors in my backyard once. I told him about the stolen generation. There wasn't a dry eye around that table. These were doctors. It hurts to talk about it. It took me, 94 was the year when I came out of it. I was looking after 5 of my grandchildren, and 2 o'clock in the morning, I broke down. My husband said to me, what's the matter with you, Cobb? And I, well, I could say to him once, I want my mommy. This was a 54-year-old grandmother crying for a mother. So So he took me back next day. We went back to New Mosia, and I was buried in New Mosia. And it was like I was going to a funeral for the first time in my life. When we came back to Northern, he said to me, I know you're full of hate. Why don't you write it down? I do believe by writing things down, it will help you. It took me 3 weeks before I can put pen to paper. And I started writing. Some days I can do 6 lines. The hurt and the tears would not be going further. Other times I can write 3 or 4 pages. This year I'm going to put my story into a book. I had a good look on Facebook. One of the girls in Perth interviewed me. Worldwide, in a day and a bit, I got 47,000 likes. That orphanage was a very cruel place. Education? What education? We didn't get an education. It was child labour. I'll tell you about one of the punishments that we got. As you know, in the 40s, there were no biros around. We had to use the old million ink block. If you blocked your paper, which most of us kids did, the little girls, 12-year-olds, under, you had to kneel out on the floor in front of the classroom with your work window on your back. These are coming from Catholic nuns, both arms outstretched with a brick. We didn't get the cane. We got the brick on each hand. The nun had a sawn off piece of broom handle, mop handle, whatever it was. So you kneeling there with a brick on your hand, naturally a child, I don't think an adult can stay that long. Your arms are going to go down with the weight of the brick. She'd come around and she noticed your hands going down and she'd hit you under the, where the brick is, under your elbow and around in the ankles. Kids walk around with swelling joints for days. We never saw a doctor. They didn't take us to the doctors. I remember one girl, about 14, was a squirrel. She had an abscess on her breast. What the nun did was crisscrossed it with a razor blade. No sedation. Will you earn a book? That's what I get from the more white people, but you were really the young book. Sorry to be a scholar. But they only knew what you went through in your life. I'd like to thank you all for listening.